Hello and welcome to a new video presented by Teleskop-Service. My name is Thorsten and in this video I want to talk about mobile astrophotography. If you are in that hobby of astrophotography, you are familiar with that look that we have here. We have a car beside me and a telescope. But if you are new to that and you're just curious what is this mobile astrophotography, please stay tuned. I have some information for you. So what's the matter with that mobile astrophotography? Well, not all of us have their own backyard observatory or a place where they can put a telescope safely overnight. So this is when we have to go somewhere else. That means in the evening you pack all your equipment, pack it into your car, drive somewhere where you have good sky, clear sky, and you set all up, do the cabling, do polar alignment, take your photos over the night, and in the morning you scrub all down and get back home. If you do it often, that will be a pretty tedious task. So you want to achieve this with the least effort possible. And for that, you should prepare your setup in some ways. So I know many of us want the big telescope, the big mount, everything super steady, rock solid. But if you are mobile, then you have to carry these parts of the equipment every evening to your car and outside. And that's very demanding. So you can prepare a setup that is specifically designed for mobile use, but of course it will perform also very good in your backyard at home. Even on your balcony, this will work too. To tell you these things a bit more practical, I have assembled a setup that I would consider for mobile use that I would also recommend. And yeah, without further ado, let's get started. Let me talk you through all the parts of the equipment that you see here. So first of all, let me start on the bottom here. What do we see here? The first thing that is very visible is this little beautiful mount here. This is the ZWO AM3 mount. So this is a so-called harmonic drive or also strain wave mount. This is a new design. Apart from the classic German equatorial mount with worm gears, these mounts utilize harmonic drives and therefore they are much more compact, lightweight, but still can carry a lot of load. So for example, that AM3 here is capable of carrying 13 kilograms of telescope load, and this without a counterweight. So you have the option to connect the counterweight bar with the counterweight here, then you can even increase that payload. That AM3 is, as I said, the newest generation of mounts that is available. It comes with three interfaces, USB, Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, so all connections are possible. On the other hand, you will only get this hand controller here. So, as you see, this is a quite simple one. You can move the telescope with that joystick here. That works like a charm, very smooth movement here. So, really nice thing, but yeah, to be honest, that's more or less all of it, what you can do with that. The intention is that you use that AM3 mount together with your smartphone or a tablet or even a PC, where you can control all the functions remote. So otherwise, that design is exactly the same as you know it from classic German equatorial mounts. You have right ascension declination, the polar alignment knobs here, all these things. So very compact design. I would this also consider to be able to pack it to your luggage when you go abroad on a plane. The mount head is roughly 3 kilograms, so very lightweight. Here on the bottom we have the original ZWO carbon tripod, the TZ40. So this is the tripod that is intended to use with that AM3, but the AM3 has a photo thread on the bottom. That means you can also use your standard photo tripod if it's able to carry the overall load. All right, so far the mount. Now let's check out the main component here, which is always the optic. I decided to go with an apochromatic refractor from TS Optics. This is the CF Apo series. Here in my case, the 90mm version. So let's say medium-sized version. They are also available in smaller form factors, 80mm and lower. Especially for a very lightweight setup, I would recommend using a smaller telescope. If you have a car, so that's not really an issue, you can also use the 90mm version. And they are available up to 155mm diameter, but this is then definitely not really mobile anymore. This refractor delivers you a very good field of view, pinpoint stars. They are all tested on the optical bench, so you get a test protocol with the telescope. Very neat and shiny thing. Retractable dew shield here. The cap is still mounted. It comes with a GP level dovetail, but the AM3 can also handle Los Mandi style, the big dovetails. And here in the back, there's also the specifically designed reducer mounted, the 0.8 reducer for that 90mm CF Apo. And this makes the telescope even faster in terms of focal ratio and gives roughly 450mm focal length. So this is what I would consider a wide field setup. Now, here is an optional part. This one is a so-called electronic focus motor. Here from ZWO, the EAF focus motor. So I say optional because normally when you do mobile photography, you are in the surrounding of your telescope. You most of the time will not let it run unattended. But if you want to, maybe you want to still have a good sleep, then a focus motor is a nice option, because it can handle refocusing in case that the HFR increases or temperature changes. All is done with that EAF, and the proper software will then do autofocus runs. Oh, I forgot one thing, just as a side note. Here on the back of the CF Apo, you have a rotator integrated. That means you can rotate your framing without changing something on the camera. It's already mounted here in between the reducer and the optic itself. It can be locked in the place that you want. Works very smooth. That's a nice addition to that overall good telescope. All right, now the setup is nearly complete. We just have one item left, and this is of course the camera. In terms of camera, you have plenty of options. For that mobile approach that we follow here, I decided to go with the brand new one from ZWO, the 2600 MC Duo. So you maybe know the 2600 family. They utilize the IMX571 sensor, let's say pretty famous sensor, because it's super versatile. It gives you APS-C format, roughly 20 megapixels, and this is just a state-of-the-art sensor with super low noise and a good quantum efficiency. So this is a sensor that is used in many cameras nowadays. And here, as the OSC version, that means I will skip the filter wheel that you need with a monochrome camera. I want it to be as compact as possible, so no filter wheel needed here. But what I have done is, here is a filter drawer mounted. An M54 filter drawer. This is needed for this duo camera, but it works with 2-inch filters. But the threading is M54, so this is pretty important, because if you use M48 or a T-thread somewhere here in that image train, it will block light from the guide sensor. And this is exactly the point that I want to talk about, the guide sensor. Normally, on such a setup, you would need a guide scope, a finder scope with an additional camera, or an off-axis guider integrated in your image train. But this duo camera already has a guide sensor integrated. That means on the same focal plane as the primary sensor is located, also a second sensor, a much smaller one, but the second sensor for guiding is integrated. And this makes the setup so compact. That means you skip one cable, one additional camera is just not needed anymore. It's all integrated here. And this is a very nice approach there. This camera type is nowadays also available as monochrome version. So then together with a filter wheel, it's also, I would still consider as compact, especially with the EFW 5 position filter wheel. This is not very big, so also the monochrome version is working very well. Now you may ask, well, guide sensor behind the filter, would this work with narrowband filters? Yes, it does. Long story short, it does, because that guide sensor is highly responsive. It is so responsive that you have to increase the exposure time, yes, but still with 4 to 5 second exposures, you will have plenty of stars for guiding. I tested it with an L-eXtreme2 filter from Optolong, works without any problems. And that's basically it all about this setup. Now, to capture images, you have to use a computer. If you use a dedicated Astro camera, you need a computer. A good approach would be, for example, an ASIR Astro computer. This one is mounted then here on the top of the telescope, and it combines all the equipment parts. It offers USB and power supply. And with that one, controlled by Wi-Fi, you can control the whole imaging process. It can also do stacking, that means image calibration, alignment and stacking, all within that single computer, which is a very good approach if you want to get photos, let's say, out of the box without much processing or something like that. I would highly recommend this. Also, other Astro computers are working. Here for this example setup, I decided to go with a notebook. Just my common Windows notebook, because when I'm abroad, when I'm on vacation, where I have the telescope with me, I also have a PC with me. And this offers me a bit more flexibility in terms of calibration and something like that. Then I can use my standard processing software to bring the photos together. There's one thing that you also have to be aware of. This is pretty important, and this is the power supply. So here I have a car with me. In principle, I can just plug in the lighter socket a cable and deliver it to the equipment. This is, let's say, a no-brainer. This is definitely working. But if you are limited, that means you don't have the car near you. You just have to walk around, or you travel with some other method. Then you need a battery pack. So, or a power tank. They are so-called power tanks. We offer them too. They offer you also a couple of connections. If you use an ASIR, you can use then that Astro computer for power delivery to the equipment. But don't forget this battery. That's really vital to be able to work over the night. And yeah, all these batteries last at least one night, so power delivery is not an issue. Here are only two components that draw power, the mount and the camera, and this is not very much, so don't worry about power consumption here. Alright, so about this setup, this is all that I can tell you, but I want also to offer you some options you have in terms of exchanges. I already mentioned the camera, where you can use a monochrome camera. Here I use an APS-C format. You can, of course, use also a smaller one, the 533, for example, or you can also use the bigger ones. You can use a full-frame camera, but there's also the thing, full-frame camera can create some problems with different telescopes. The CF Apo series is able to illuminate a full-frame, but if you use a fast Newtonian, then you may have issues with collimation. And this brings us to the optic. I use this apochromatic refractor here because it's just the most simple way for astrophotography. The collimation is settled in factory, and they are tested and shipped with that setting. And normally the collimation will not change. If it does, it's a major problem, but normally it stays very long time in place. For mirror telescopes like a Newtonian, collimation is definitely an issue if you drive around by car, then the collimation can be affected. This is why I would be very careful when using a Newtonian for such a setup. But it's definitely also working. If you already have a Newtonian, especially a smaller one, a 6-inch or maybe an 8-inch f4, something fast, then you can of course try it. If you're familiar with that collimation, that's not the big issue. If not, you have to try out collimation at home where you have your usual surroundings. That's pretty important to know the procedure. What I would recommend is, for example, a Ritchey-Chrétien telescope. 6-inch Ritchey-Chrétien is extremely compact, gives you very long focal lengths. If you're targeting more smaller objects like galaxies or planetary nebula, something like that, a small Ritchey-Chrétien will do the job. Also, keep in mind, collimation may be affected. And last but not least, the mount. It's also exchangeable. If the budget is the point, of course you can use a classic German equatorial mount. When you drive by car, you should be able to handle this. Starting with a EQ3 class, which I would not really recommend for serious astrophotography, to a EQ5 class, which is also still mobile, up to the bigger ones, but the bigger ones are then also very heavy. If you need to use a big mount, then I can recommend the ZWO AM5. This is the same harmonic drive type, but it is, as I said, just bigger. It can carry more payload, more than 20 kilograms, and it's also attachable with a counterweight, so then you can also increase that payload even more. It's then a bit heavier, yes, but yeah, if you have a big setup, then the AM5 may be a proper choice for your telescope. All right, so that's it. That's what I want to tell you about mobile astrophotography. I'm just waiting here for darkness, and then I will use the scope and doing some great shots here in the wild. I'm really curious about the performance. If there was any good shot, then here are the shots.